मॉर्निंग क्लास, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज करोजन. करोजन मीन्स ईटन अप ऑफ द मेटल्स बाय एनवायरमेंटल फैक्टर्स लाइक एयर, वॉटर and other impurities. That means air, water and carbon dioxide etc. many other impurities are striking with metal and its first layer, its shine is lost. So what are the conditions required for rusting or corrosion? First is presence of metal. Second is presence of air, that is oxygen is required for rusting. Third condition is water. If three factors are there, that is metal is there, oxygen is there and water is there, then only corrosion will take place. Otherwise, if one factor will be removed, then corrosion will not take place. So, what are the losses that you are bearing when metal is getting corroded? First thing, in case of iron. Iron, when striking with oxygen, water, it forms iron oxide. X water molecules means certain amount of water molecules are combining with it. It is forming rust, or you can balance it in this way, 4Fe plus 3O2 plus X water molecules can give you rust. In case of silver, sulfur is combining with silver to form silver sulfide. Silver articles get black. After that, if you are taking any copper article, you can see it gets tarnished and its green color appears. It reacts with carbon dioxide to form copper carbonate. That all is due to corrosion. Its green color appears. Its black color appears and its brown color appears. That all is due to corrosion of metals. If any bridge is made in which iron articles are used, iron bars are used, and it is getting rust, that means its age will be very less. It will break down in some years. Similarly, if iron bars are used in your household lanterns and all, that means its age is also getting depleted. So before using, we can make iron coating with any paint, oil, so that its contact with air can be broken. So what can be the methods in which corrosion can be prevented? First method can be making a layer or coating over the surface of metal so that it can't react with air. That is, it can be painted or it can be oil or galvanized. Galvanization means we are making layer of zinc over the surface of metal. Or any other method which can be used is alloying. What is alloying? Alloying means making mixture of metal with metal or metal with non-metal. In such a way that its corrosion can be prevented. Like in case of iron, we are combining it with carbon. See, iron articles are made up of iron atoms. Iron atom is having atomic number 26, that means bigger atoms. And in places where the atoms of iron are not there, that is interatomic spaces can be filled with carbon. It can be compared with the arrangement in which we are making a stack of footballs, and in the places between the footballs we can fit in tennis balls so that nothing can get inside. In this way, iron atoms are covered between carbon atoms so that air, water can't get enter in, so steel don't get corroded. In the same way, we can mix iron with nickel and chromium. To make stainless steel. In this way, alloys can be made and corrosion can be prevented. Rancidity. Rancidity is oxidation of oil or fat. You must have noticed, if your mom makes pakoras in the evening and next morning you try to take that pakoras, you will get foul smell in that. What is that? That is oiled food items. When oxidized, it gives you foul smell. That is due to oxidation of oiled food. It gives you foul smell and bad taste. How it can be prevented? It can be prevented by making fresh food, or it can be prevented by packing the packets with nitrogen. Like your chips packets are flushed with nitrogen, so that nitrogen is making a layer around the chips and it don't let oxygen to get enter in and oxidize your food items. It can be refrigerated. Things can be kept in fridge to avoid oxidation of your oiled food items.